the bodies.
Yeah.
think that's all of them.
The fort appears sound. The Inquisition might make use of it.
Payday, yeah? Let's get some merchants in your new house.
Mr. Nightingale, tell you why she wanted agents here?
We lie on the main road between Denham and BioWare. Couriers stop here all the time. For all they're paid, some have surprisingly loose tongues.
When's this spy named Butcher supposed to arrive?
Half hour ago, by the south gate. I hope he's only delayed. Butcher's last message swore he had secrets for us worth 10 times his weight in gold.
What's happening in Crestwood?
Many undead keep rising from the lake.
I should be going.
Farewell.
Here, the mayor said the dam controls were through this gate.
And what else did Lady Forsythia say? That she'd rather drown herself than help the Inquisition. Anything else? She said she'd have us flogged alive if we allied with her brother. That does sound like her. Cheer up, Josie. We at least have her attention. You always do find the brighter side of things. We are in the midst of cementing an alliance with Lady Forsythia of Nevara, Your Worship. It's become a somewhat delicate task.
She'll have us flogged alive?
I believe she meant flayed alive. Her ladyship tends to confuse metaphors when she's excitable. I dissuaded her from sending soldiers when she learned we'd struck an accord with a brother she's feuding with. Lady Forsythia simply employs a colorful manner of speech.
Do you always apologize for bloodthirsty nobles?
It's the usual showmanship expected from those in power, Inquisitor. Nothing more. But I confess I do miss my staff from the embassy in Antiva. It was always useful to discuss the day's visitors with them.
I have time, if you'd like to review things with me.
I wouldn't wish to impose.
If it were imposing, I wouldn't have offered.
Well, I admit there are a few potential alliances it would be good to discuss. Right on the parlor floor, in front of everyone at the soiree. Who does such a thing in front of their guests?
The Duke of Kellington, apparently.
And then there's Cole's lurking. It frightens our guests half to death. Lord Jynarr still won't respond to our letters. And Sarah, can she not find a single overshirt without mustard stains on it? Then there's Dorian. The man refuses to take anything seriously unless it suits its whim. Not to mention... Oh, goodness. Have we been here an hour already?
Two and a half hours, I think, but no one's counting.
Oh, dear. I didn't intend to go on for so long. You must think me quite the gossip.
You've been working continually since I met you, Josephine.
And that can't stop. I must be going. But I leave feeling less troubled than I have in weeks.